Yo, what up, y'all? This is Garren. I'm chilling at the number one space with Cool Cat, Norfolk, Virginia. Stand up.
You know what I mean?
Yo, first off, tell the people who you are, man. Where you from? All that good stuff.
I'm Garren. I'm from Compton. It's South Central. Los Angeles, all that. I'm just a young man that's trying to create the world back to normal. Bring the world back to normal.
So what brings you to north of Vieta?
God. I mean, but besides that, my talent and the gift he gave me, just to be able to come and share, you know, what I've worked on for my whole life with other people from different places, and Norfolk happened to be one of the places, so I'm grateful.
How did you get started with music? How did you get into it?
I didn't really choose it. So I kind of, like, ever since I can remember, I've been doing music, so it kind of wasn't something that I had to start. It was just always a part of me. But I have this auntie, her name is Auntie Krista. God used her to allow me to be used as a vessel for the world. So, church, God, my Auntie Krista, my big brother Greg, my big cousin Chris, my big cousin Nick Smith. It's too many people I can name that would allow me to be able to express that. They were the reason that I got here, you know? So, it's so hard to name 1, 2, 15, 20. It's like 1,000 people. I'll always forget somebody. That's how many people helped me get to this point.
Who's your influence? Yeah, if you have
one. Brandy. Gospel music. My Auntie Krista, who I was telling you about. Jay Moss, like, it's a lot. It gets deep. Red Jumpsuit Apparatus. Explosions in the Sky. It's a lot. It variates. It can be rock, Christian, rap, R&B, hip-hop. It just depends on what mood I'm in.
So far, how you liking Norfolk, VA? VA weird.
VA great. I love VA.
I know it ain't got no Cali weather.
No, it ain't the Cali weather, but look, I'm really enjoying myself. It's real chill. It seemed like if I was retired, I'd come to VA. And just, like, you know, get my mind right. Or just, like, own some property out here by the lake. Get my mind right. 2 weeks, bring my family or something, like, you know?
Yeah.
It's one of those type of spots. Like, it ain't like too much going on at one time. Like, LA, it's always something going on.
Always.
It's like 10 different things happening at one time.
So, you ain't seen the dark side yet.
I ain't seen the dark side.
So, any new music coming out, bro? Any things in the works?
Yeah, it's a lot of new music coming out. I got a lot of music dropping at the top of the year. I'm always be committing myself to releasing, you know, a nice body of work multiple times, and not just like this one thing, because I know people want to hear stuff faster now in today's world, so I'm gonna commit myself to, like, feeding the people, but at the same time, I'm a singer, and I'm a true singer, I'm a belter, I'm like a crooner. Is that what they call it, a crooner?
I think so.
I think it's a crooner.
So quality over quantity.
Yeah, quality. I'm super quality. So I'm gonna sing my heart out, but I ain't about to flood the streaming platforms with Garren music, because I want to, you know,
make it stick.
I want to make it stick, yeah. And I want the value to be there, because if you always know I'm gonna release something 10 times a year, you might just download it 3 times.
because they value.
Yeah, the value.
If you keep coming at them, but it makes you seem more rare.
Anything you do too much of, listen too much of, hear too much of, see too much of, feel too much of, it loses its value as time goes because it's too much. So if it's too much Garren music out there, then you won't value it as much. So I'm strategic about how I, you know, go about releasing music.
So off this tour, bro, what's the craziest story you got so far? If you can share it, if not.
Oh yeah, I don't be really getting too crazy, but the homie Cy, Ari the Kid, had some girls come on stage and he was like damn near humping them on stage. Like it was just wild, like it was just too much at one time.
I actually got that on camera.
Oh, you did? Yeah, I went backstage, it was chill, came back, and he was humping somebody, you know, I was just like... Wow, that's probably the craziest moment. But I was watching, I wasn't really a part of it, I was just watching it.
Facts.
But it was like funny, I was just like,
okay.
What was drastic that happened between me leaving and coming back? Yeah.
0 to 100?
Yeah, it was 0 to 100 real quick. Facts.
What's the best place on tour that you visited thus far?
Best place? I gotta say Norfolk for the way we've been treated.
Yeah?
Yeah, I feel like we've been treated very, very well. And just, you know, I feel like we in a beautiful spot, I guess, in Norfolk, wherever we stand. But it's about like a lake and shit, so.
You got the scenery.
Yeah, so I'm appreciative of the moment. 2 days, it's our only off day, but it's really not off day because we here working. So, you know, it's just good to see this side of y'all city, I guess.
It has its ups and downs, bro. We have a lot to offer. We just got to know. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I'm sure. I mean, I feel like any city has a lot to offer. You just got to find the right people to get with to offer that.
Yes, sir. So is there any advice that you want to give to the people that's chasing their dreams, trying to pursue a path in anything? Whether it's music.
Some sound advice. What I would say is, don't worry about what's going on around you to propel yourself to the next level. You know, sometimes, and most times, from my experience, everything that's going on around you kinda is the opposite of where you're trying to go. So, if you just kind of grasp that you chasing a dream, which is kind of like imagination, you have to kind of create this imaginary world around you. So what might look like negativity might just be positivity in your imaginary world. And you looking at it in a positive way will help you have the mentality to receive what you're working for. Maybe that didn't make sense, but if you just rewind it, boom, 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 boom.
I felt that.
Play it again.
Perception is everything.
You got it.
Yes, sir. Well, look, bro, I really appreciate you coming out to Norfolk, bro. I really appreciate this interview.
Yeah.
Continue to kill it, bro. I'm a new fan of your music.
Yeah.
I rock with you.
Yeah, man, that's love.